to the markets overall. I think they've been unaffected recently by political scandal. David Barnson is with us. He's the author of the very good book, Crisis of Responsibility. I don't think the market cares that much about political scandal at this moment. I think they care more about profits and momentum. What say you?
I agree with you 100%, except for I take out those words "at this moment." They never care about anything other than profits. Now, to the degree scandals could affect profits, but that is very rare historically, and it's completely non-existent in this silly Trump-Russia collusion nonsense.
Well, wait a second. You do get movement in the Dow and the S&P.
But that's
momentary reaction.
Okay, so 3 days last year. There were 3 days of movement, not even reaching to a 2% level. I'm saying fundamentally, markets are, on a day-to-day basis, dealing with noise, but earnings are what markets reflect. Earnings are not affected by what one day is released and leaked and this and that. It's just silly. There's fatigue in our society. Yep. And as you referenced my book, I think there's a crisis of responsibility that's playing out in this nonsense with former FBI Director Comey. It's embarrassing to the country. It really is. It doesn't affect markets. Markets are just too money driven, which is how it ought to be. That's why we call them markets.
Excellent, David. I want to talk about GE. The stock is doing very nicely today, up about 4%. It approached 50, it actually hit $15 a share earlier this morning. What do you make of GE?
Yeah, when a stock is down to the low teens, a 4% move becomes pretty easy. You know, 60, 70 cents will do it. But it was a good earnings release. And speaking of profits, that's what drove the stock price higher. They had better earnings than expected. The issue is that cash flows that are sustainable, repeatable, which was the heart of their business forever. They had these monstrous annuitized cash flow businesses. They're gone. They're not there. They're not part of the assets of GE's portfolio right now. They had to sell off a lot of things post-financial crisis. We need to see a better strategic plan in place.
You're not playing around with GE at $14 a share. You're shaking your head.
We're not traders. We're not jumping in to buy things on a trade. It was one of the great sells I've had. We sold it at $32 in anticipation of a dividend cut that came at $22. Now the stock's at $14. We feel good about that. I love the history of the company, but I need to see growing cash flows that lead to growing dividends for me to be interested.
Last time you were on the show, you said buy Exxon. Mm-hmm. It was that back then it was $78 a share.
Back then, last Friday, yes.
Last Friday. Yeah.
All the way back
All the way back last Friday. Now, you also liked energy stocks overall. I've got Schlumberger on the screen at the moment. Less revenue came over the transom there, and the stock is down. Are you still saying energy stocks, oil companies, major oils like Exxon are the place to be?
Absolutely. And so I would say Schlumberger is this sort of oil services company. It's very CapEx heavy. It's up over 10% in the last couple weeks. So the fact it's down a dollar today isn't a big surprise. It's literally up over 10% in the near term. But we think it's a $100 stock. It's trading around 70. They're the leader in a business that is really a complicated business. It fluctuates with commodity price, and it's cyclical to the degree that projects come on, they come in and support the projects, get paid a lot to do it, and it's global. Exxon is a different story. Exxon, it benefits from any part of the cycle. One silo of their business is benefiting. I think it's up a buck or buck and a half since we were on last week.
Nice, 78.
It should be in the high 78s, so what I saw this morning, 78.50 now, and we were talking about it last week in the 77s. But this is a company that has the best balance sheet of any energy company in history, and through time just continues to grow cash flows, very innovative, wonderful leadership. The other thing we talked about, though, I want to keep coming back to the pipelines, those that have to transport it. I read this week, it fascinates me, they're getting so much production out of the Permian Basin in Texas.
In Texas, yeah.
That now the prices are having to drop for that oil because they have to put it on a truck to get it because there's not enough pipelines to ship the oil around. And so they have to go to a more expensive way to transport it. The pipelines are an incredible story to invest in right now for growth and income.
Give me the name of a pipeline company.
Enterprise Products is a big one, but another name to play it is Blackstone, who's investing so heavily in the space, bought a big pipeline management company last year for $10 billion. So Blackstone is a way to get, they have a number of energy private equity funds. That's a way to play it. Enterprise Products is the biggest, EPD, one of the leaders in the space. I said MLPs last week, and they put Maui Pineapple up on the TV, so I want to be careful this week, clarify.
Oh, by the way, full disclosure, I have bought bought some shares of the Blackstone Group, BX.
Okay. Wonderful company, sort of cream of the crop business, but then very fee-based businesses. Their earnings came out yesterday, grew their assets under management that pay revenue 23% year over year.
Oof. Again, full disclosure, I did buy some of it yesterday at the high, as a matter of fact.
I'm glad to hear you did.
David, thanks for joining us, sir. Appreciate it.